which indicate what? First, the rapidly with which account receivable are collected. Which ratio we should calculate for this? So they have not directly asked the question as we did in previous question, whereby they have asked you to compute this ratio, that ratio, and so on so forth. Here they are indirectly asking for this, which particular ratio you are going to calculate? No. Try to understand again. Account receivable are collected. Account receivable are collected. GP ratio is not right answer. I'm giving you chance. So this kind of question also may be asked in your exam, whereby they may not ask directly from you to compute this ratio or that ratio. They may ask like this, which ratio we should compute which give us the answer of rapidly with which account receivable are collected. What do you mean by account receivable? Anyone? What do you mean by account receivable? Account receivable means what? Have you ever heard in your life the word bills receivable?
Yes, sir.
So bills receivable and accounts receivable is same. Account receivable even incorporate debtors and bills receivable. Debtors and receivable. Okay. So if this is the case, then which ratio will help us? The ratio will be, yes, now Harsh has given me right answer. Debtors turnover ratio or average collection period. Just check. Debtors turnover ratio or average collection period. These are the ratio which will help us. Yes or no? See. So then we need to calculate this. So first they have calculated debtors turnover ratio, then collection period. These are the ratio of combined. Okay. Next week we will be going to practice this. Okay. But this is a different type of question. So that is why I wanted to have a discussion today, whereby they will not directly going to ask which ratio to be computed. They will check your ability by applying the concept of ratio calculation or ratio analysis. You have to first decide which ratio and then compute that ratio. So what here they have identified, they identified that debtors turnover ratio and the collection period is 73 days. 73 days is the collection period for receivable and debtors. Next is the ability of the company to make current obligations. The ability of the company to meet its current obligations. Very nice. Yesterday also we had a lot of discussion on this. Okay, I have given you one example also of two students who has taken the money and all of a sudden they neither repaid or they were not able to meet each other. And one fine day, once that student has been met with each other, immediately she has given her 5,000 rupees with 1,000 interest, or she went to the bank ATM and withdrawn the money and given. So if immediately she can repay, that means her immediate solvency is very high. To pay the immediate liability, she has enough immediate current assets. To pay off the immediate current liability, she has lot of immediate current asset, which is known as liquid asset or quick asset. Okay, but if she is going to the bank and collecting the fund and getting it repaid to her, then it is known as current ratio, yes, which is for liquidity, which is for short-term solvency. These are known as short-term. First one is known as immediate solvency, then which is quick ratio. Second one is short-term solvency, which is known as current ratio, and then is long-term solvency. All balance sheet ratios are giving the solvency position only. See, try to understand the position of Thakur College. They can able to operate the college. Okay, why? Because that entire asset is belonging to them. But some classes which is going on right now, we have MPSC, UPSC for those exams. We have the, you know, courses. So in such cases, if you want to keep them their long-term solvency, it is not there. Earlier we had IIT classes, they all have been vanished. It's ability of the college. So the classes long-term solvency at Thakur College is very low. Why? Because they are on rental premises. They don't have their own fixed asset. Okay, any moment of time college may say please go out and they have to leave. But if you'll talk about their liquidity position, their short-term solvency position, that is very high. So this is how you need to compute the solvency, which is very, very integral part for any company. So to meet the current obligation, as you have rightly stated, is current ratio. See? And what is the industry's standard? 2:1. So to pay off 1 lakh of current liability, you should always have 2 lakhs of current asset. Here it is little low. It is 1.7:1. No problem. But it is still there in a sufficient way. But if it would have been, only 0.7:1, then it would have been dangerous for the company. And that is what has happened with big aviation companies like Jet Airways or Kingfisher Airways. They were having aircraft, but to repay the current liabilities, salary, rent, taxes, payment for fuel, they were not having current assets. So, badi company which operated 30 years vanished. Why? Because their liquidity position was not up to the mark. They could not able to done appropriate ratio analysis, management accounting application, and that entire company, after so much effort, you don't know how much effort it takes for making a brand and creating a brand for 30 years. If you see again, yes, here also I can tell you the difference between long-term solvency and short-term solvency. that Jet Airways has been liquidated because they could not repay 15,000 crores of loan credit to the different banks. Whereas if you talk about Air India, they have every quarter almost 15,000 crore ka loss, but then also they could able to sustain. Why? Because they are government funded. This entire airport is belongs to them. They have huge premises, so all fixed asset belongs to them. So now you must have understood the difference between long term solvency and short term solvency, which is very much vital when we are computing balance sheet ratio. Solvency can be even given the name as liquidity or different nomenclature. Like here it is given current obligations likewise. What markup has been attained? Please, all the students, kindly next to this keep a note and write down these are the ratio through which we can get the answer of this question. So for rapid with which account receivable are collected, we need to compute debtors turnover ratio and average collection period. Here we need to, for ability of the company to meet the current obligation, we need to calculate current ratio to know what markup has been attended, what ratio to be calculated. Can you tell me? Percentage ratio. See, with which ratio you can identify that company has achieved something or they have not achieved something. Just recollect. What was the ratio which we computed through which we could able to make out that company has achieved or some? Yes, they are known as profitability ratio. Absolutely right. So markup has been attended or not, that can be identified only and only with profits. Okay, gross profit ratio, net profit ratio, these are the profit which will advise us by this much has been allotted and this much you have achieved or not achieved. That cannot be done with quick ratio or current ratio or proprietary ratio or debtors turnover ratio. You agree with me or not? Do you agree with me or not? Thank you. So in such cases, we need to compute profitability ratio. Let me see what is the condition over here for this company. The profitability is 25%. Now tell me, this 25% is okay for the company or not okay for the company? Tell me. If suppose you will keep the funds with bank, how much interest you will get? How much returns you will get? ₹4%. And if you have operated with you have done your business, okay, so you are getting 25%, which is better option. So 25% returns is very good return. Of course, as much as we will get, if we'll get 50%, it is much better. So when we get more than the bank interest, Okay, when we get long-term returns, in such cases, it's better that we should invest in business. Next is the efficiency with which fund represented by inventories are being utilized and managed. The efficiency with which fund represented by inventories are being utilized and managed. One more thing, of course, first you get me this answer. Kindly complete the previous topic assignment as well. Okay. And the questions where we have dictated you the comments, they are very, very important. Actually, in the company, this all you will get it from ready-made available of the software. Computer will give you all these ratios, but you have to apply your extraordinary brain logic to have the strategic management, for have strategic planning for long-term decision making, etc. Yes, you both are right, Harsh and Aryan. Yes, this is the efficiency which with funds represented by inventories. Inventory means stock. Are being utilized and managed. Okay. And that is why in the ratio computation, in the ratio formula, when I have given it to you, I have very clearly stated the purposes why we compute these ratios. No, these are the purposes. You know the stock turnover, inventory turnover, or their management. So it's very, very important that you. That is why after applying so much of things, I have created this kind of formula set for all the students, which is helping them in all different kind of questions. Yes, you both are right. To know the efficiency of the fund and inventory management. Or the funds being utilized, we need to compute stock turnover ratio. Let us see how the position of stock turnover ratio in this company, 2.5 times, quite okay, hana? 2.5 times, do dhai bar. Actually, it must be better if they can rotate for more period of time. As well as they have also computed stock working capital ratio. Why stock working capital ratio? This is very important. Why stock working capital ratio? Because we have computed the current assets upon current liability, but amongst that current assets, we have huge amount of closing stock. And if there is a huge amount of closing stock, then liquidity is not fast. Why liquidity is not fast? Why we are not taking stock as a quick current asset? Because we have stock. In lockdown also, many people, many garment store, they were having stock. But stock se cash mila kya unko? Rolling got stock. So stock is non-quick current asset. Bank balance, cash balance, bank mein jo paisa tha, usse unko fayda mila ki nahin? Immediately liquidate kar paaye ki nahin? Yes. So stock is non-quick because until unless the new customer comes, they agree with the price what you have quoted and they are having cash to pay. Till then it is non-quick. Stock and prepaid expenses are known as non-quick current assets. And similarly, bank overdraft and cash credit is known as non-quick current liability. I hope you will remember forever. Next we have the ability of the company to meet quickly demand for payment of amount due. No. It's not like that. Current asset for 12 months, we should not wait. Who has written all this? Who has written 7703? It's not, it is wrong perception. And if someone has taught you, it is wrong. It is not stated that 12 months we should wait. See, think about the businesses who had many current assets, who has stock. Now those businesses got bankrupt after lockdown. Current asset means as and when we required to repay the quick current liabilities they should have. Okay, to repay the electricity bill. Why this company has went to the liquidation? They were not having funds to repay their rent. They were not having funds to continue the same staff without working. So there were problems. Liability of the company, many of you have written very rightly, quick ratio is absolutely right answer. Let us see what is the condition of quick ratio over here. 0.9:1, not good. Not good. Actually 1:1 should be there. Okay. Last one, the relative importance of proprietary and liabilities at source of fund. The relative importance of the proprietary. Proprietorship and liability as source of fund. Yeah. So now try to understand what was the formula for proprietor ratio. Proprietor's fund upon total asset. Yes, no. So we wanted to know how much is the total asset belongs to the proprietor. Or proprietor should be in a position to assist or to get the total funds utility, or if they required, they can repay and they can buy, so on and so forth. Okay. So that is why here the proprietary ratio is so important. I hope today you must have learned a different kind of ratio computation, which is very helpful for all of us. It is logical. It is going to help us for our personal and professional life. Next week, we will be having our combined ratio. And meanwhile, you all complete your assignment as early as possible. Thank you and all the best for your rest of the exam, internal exam. Kindly do well in the internal exam. Bye and take care.